Right, Neil, well, firstly, congratulations and welcome to the football club.
Yeah, no, it's my absolute privilege to be here. And, you know, Essendon's one of the great clubs of the AFL, fantastic history, highly successful, you know, 16 premierships, a power club of the AFL. So it's a real exciting period, you know, for me to come to the and to be involved and be part of the Essendon Footy Club. So I'm really looking forward to it.
Was that something that sort of lured you to the job, the fact that Essendon was one of the four big clubs in Melbourne?
Yeah, well, coming from interstate, you know, you obviously follow the AFL. You know, even when I was a little kid, you know, there was Essendon, there was Collingwood, there was Carlton, you know, and, you know, Richmond and then the Hawthorn, of course, probably now. And there is something special about the big clubs, and Essendon's, with its, as I said, with its history and its successful record, you know, it's an attraction to people involved in footy, and certainly during my discussions, you know, with the football club, that was in the background. So it's something for all their supporters and their sponsors to be really proud of.
Can you explain to us how you came across the role and obviously the process in securing the job?
Yeah, well, the role's a really interesting one, Jeremy. It's a role that's starting to evolve in a lot of AFL clubs at the moment. And that's occurred, of course, because of the growth of football departments, the complexity, the workload on senior coaches, the accountability now and responsibility on assistant coaches and development coaches, as well as pulling, you know, all your support staff together to service the playing group. So, you know, when you start to look at it that way, you know, this is why this sort of role is starting to evolve. So it's sort of it's reorganising the organisational structure, if you like. You know, it's a new role. So it's evolving. I spent 2 years at Melbourne in a similar role, which I really enjoyed. You know, so I bring some learnings, having been 2 years in that role, to the footy club here. Predominantly, it's about working really strongly and closely with the coaches. You know, giving Mark a lot of support where and when he needs it. You know, and particularly working with the development coaches, being involved in the Essendon way of playing footy and the training environment that they actually want to generate here, so that becomes your culture and the way you prepare and the way you play. So that's really exciting for me. That's a real interest for me to be involved in that. And I guess having been involved in high performance sport for a long period of time, 30 odd years, you know, you bring those experiences and hopefully wisdom and some knowledge. So, you know, an old owl is probably not the way to call it, but you know, you bring those sort of skills, and I'm really looking forward to being involved with it.
What excites you most about your new role at Essendon?
Well, I obviously sat outside the club last year, and I look at the Essendon Footy Club. Really tough year for the club, but I just like the way they play their footy. It's an aggressive style. It's an exciting style. I love the way the supporters hung in there and continued to support their footy club, and I'm sure the sponsors and the coterie groups were the same. So that says something about the club, even though it was a really tough year for it. You know, the enormity of Essendon in the AFL, the history of it, where it sits, and certainly in my discussions with Ray Gunston, Chris Heffernan and Paul Little, and towards the end with Mark, it was pretty clear about where they want to go. It's a pretty exciting vision that they've got, so I want to be part of that.
Can you talk us through how you did sit down and you had a chat with Mark, and obviously you got to work together?
Yeah, no, I mean, probably towards, you know, I had a lot of discussion with Chris and Ray Gunston and the board at one stage, and Paul Little in particular. You know, quite a few discussions. I mean, just that's probably them doing their due diligence and vice versa. But at some stage, you know, I did get a chance to sit with Mark, you know, who I've obviously been a senior coach myself. You coached against Mark. I didn't know him that well, but it was a great 2 or 3 hours that we spent just basically talking about football philosophies, how this role works with his role, you know, possible scenarios where there can be conflict. So let's try and put those on the table now. So it was a great 2 or 3 hours. I'm sure there'll be some things that we didn't discuss that will come up, but in general, you know, I left that meeting feeling really comfortable. That can be a strong, and it needs to be a really strong working relationship So I'm sure it'll be a great working relationship for both parties.
Obviously, you've got a two-year contract. Mark's senior coach for 2014, but James then returns in 2015.
Yeah.
Have you sat down with James and obviously discussed your philosophies?
Yeah,
and the
plan? Look, just part of the due diligence for me. It was I thought it was appropriate for me to be able to do that, and it was just first of all just for James' well-being, you know, just himself, because he's obviously had a really tough year, you know, and all senior coaches have sort of. Understand the stress of the job, you know, on top of what he went through. So it was really just a check to see how he's going, but also just a general philosophy about footy, how he sees things. That made sense to me to do that because James is coming back in 2015. And so it was important that, you know, we weren't poles apart in the way we think about footy. And once again, I walked out of that meeting, you know, really confident that, you know, it would be exciting to better work with James when he comes back.
I take it you've had a fairly decent look at our list, and where do you see it progressing, and what do we need to work on to make
this? Yeah, well, it's sort of the actual list itself. I mean, it's really interesting when you're sort of an opposition coach or you're working in another footy club. You know the list, but you don't know them in detail. So that'll unfold. You'll get to know the players, you know, to the level you need to know them. Most of my work will be probably one back from the playing group. The majority of time, it'll really be about working strongly with the coaches, you know, accountability, responsibility for what they're doing, professional development, increasing their skills, because we talk about development of a group, playing group, of course we do, but that development will only be as good as the coaches around them. So part of my role is to spend as much time and share as, you know, as much as my experience and background as I can, and that's what will happen.
I guess most importantly, when do you start?
Today. I'm ready to go. So there's some work that we can start right away, you know. So I'm ready to go. I'm looking forward to it.
Congratulations, Neil, on your appointment to the job.
No, absolute. My pleasure to be here. Looking forward to it.